Hi everybody, welcome back to 30 Days Until Done. Today we're going to be looking at Van Gogh's haystacks, but in an interesting way. I've put the link down below, you can follow the link. It's a clip from Kurosawa's final movie, Kurosawa, the great Japanese director, and where he depicts Van Gogh out in the fields painting the haystacks, right? Which is one of Van Gogh's best paintings, and certainly one of his most famous paintings. And he tries to give an explanation as to why Van Gogh cut off his ear and all of that. And it's an interesting thing. But here's the thing, though. Okay, so we're talking about poetic conversations about art. Now we're having a conversation with Kurosawa. This is a very interesting conversation that Kurosawa had, because he's, of course, paying homage to Van Gogh, this great artist. And this is Kurosawa's, the great Kurosawa. You know, he did Seven Samurai, he did Yojimbo. He has this incredible career. He's an amazing artist, right? He's got all of these years of doing all of these amazing films. I was shocked when this movie came out. What was the name of the movie?
Dreams.
Dreams. I was shocked when Dreams came out because I figured that he died 20 years earlier. I didn't realize he was still working. And this was his last thing. And so he's paying tribute to this, but and also having conversation with Van Gogh about the nature of art and the nature of creation and stuff. But at the same time, he's cast Martin Scorsese as Van Gogh, which is a bit of a tribute to Scorsese. But of course, Scorsese is doing tribute to Kurosawa, because, you know, the great director Kurosawa. And so we've got all of these artists together talking about the nature of art and what it means to be an artist and what is the nature of insanity when you're coming towards where you're going towards art. Because Dreams is all about the unconscious and what the unconscious does for the artist. And of course, Van Gogh is famously lost it. He's cut off his own ear, I'm not sure what the whole deal is. But he gives an explanation as to what it is. And Scorsese, of course, is in there paying homage, but also having a conversation about what is the nature of art and insanity and all of that stuff. So here's what we have. We have a very placid scene painted by someone who is in turmoil. Right, and he's something's going on with Van Gogh, and by this very nature of what's happening and who he is, we're cut off from him. So, and we're having a lot of people having conversations trying to figure him out. And now you and I can enter into that conversation as well. Okay, so when you're done with this, now what would I write about? I would write about Scorsese, and I don't know why. Because he's the person who it doesn't have its own voice in this, right? He's kind of honoring everyone so much that he's given his voice over to Kurosawa. It's just my presence alone. It's kind of a George Washington move, isn't it? George Washington, who famously would go to these important events and not say anything. He'd just sit there, and it was his presence. He understood that he had such presence that he didn't have to talk at the Constitutional Convention, and he didn't. When they're ratifying the Declaration of Independence, he doesn't have to do anything. He just has to be there, and it's kind of what Scorsese is doing. I think I'm not sure. It's just his presence has added something. Also, he probably really, really wanted to be in a Kurosawa film. I mean, who doesn't? I want to. It's too bad he's dead for multiple reasons. Also, my selfish ones. Anyway, that's 30 Days Until Done. When you're done, post down below, and I will see you tomorrow.